Good morning, good morning, good morning. This is Pastor Jay with Anointed Radio. And like always, we're going to go ahead and get started in decency and order. And we're going to come out of Proverbs 19 and 20. And it says, listen to advice and accept discipline. And at the end, you will count among the wise. If you listen to advice and accept discipline in your life, you'll have decency and order. And it will help you. It won't harm you. Amen. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing us here, God. Thank you for bringing us into the station safely. Bless this broadcast. Let somebody that's listening be able to be blessed. Let them be able to know that you are God. God, we just thank you this morning to helping us wake up to the rising sun, to know that we have new grace and new mercy this morning. Bless everybody that's waking up. Bless everybody that's on their way to church. Bless everybody that is just rolling over and listening. God, we just thank you for all the things that you're doing. Continue to be a blessing in our life. And God, we just thank you and we honor you. We say that all in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Welcome back. We are back. It's been a crazy week. Chris is in the building.
Hey.
It's like we trade for people. Like, we got Chris in the building, but then we ain't got Dr. Marvinetta in the building.
Right.
So we got trade for people. We're like, all right, today we're going to trade. We're going to switch. Then they're going to be here, and then I'm not going to be here. And then, you know, it'd be like that. But, hey, I don't think that's going to ever happen, though.
Probably not.
No, I don't think that ever going to happen. So right now we're streaming from YouTube.
Yeah, so go to YouTube.
So go to YouTube, y'all. It's crazy. And actually, to give a kind of a cursor for 2020, we will no longer be streaming on Facebook. We're going to be now streaming like how we are doing today. It might be a little early because how systems are working today.
All right.
But we're going to YouTube.
All right.
So
YouTube it is, huh?
We're going to be on YouTube, y'all. So check us out on YouTube. That's how we is. Anointed Radio on YouTube, y'all. Check it out. Check it out. We are live right now. And like always, this is Pastor Jay. You can find me at Anointed Jaylon, y'all. Anointed Jaylon on Instagram and Twitter. You can find me at Pastor Jaylon. So if you at Pastor Jaylon, J-A-Y-L-O-N, you can find me, y'all. Just put the ad on there. And then Pastor Jaylon, man, like that. So, yeah. It's good to be back, yo.
Amen.
Oh, yeah. The crazy thing is, so my doctor told me, so because I'm going to have to tell y'all this story because it really bothered me. My doctor told me I have upper respiratory infection where I got all this mucus and no toothbrush. Mm-hmm. When I was trying to use the water boy comparison, but didn't work. No, it didn't work at all. So I had to cancel my trip to DC for the awards that I was nominated to. But definitely go check out the SpeakerCon Awards Live 2019, where I was nominated for faith-based speaker and for podcaster of the year.
Amen.
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 I probably didn't win because I'm not going to be able to go. But give them some support. Shout them out. It's going to be great. It's coming up November 1st to the 2nd. And, yeah, it's going to be cool. But that was me, Pastor Jay, passing the mic.
And this is Chris Johnson. You can find me at St. Chris Jay on all social media outlets. You can also find me on my website at stchrisjay.com. And can't forget about Dr. Clay. I think it's Dr. Marvinetta Clay. Marvinetta Clay Marvinetta,
Clay M. Marvinetta.
Yeah, what? All of them. Just find, pick one of them.
Right.
And you can find her everywhere.
Everywhere. And you know, what I was thinking about. Oh yeah, how her name is, like, she's the love child of Marvin Gaye and Etta James.
Right.
Marvinetta. There you go. There it is. You got me a song about it. You want to hear it? Well, here you go. So we are, I guess, we are trying to think. We gotta go into announcements.
We have church announcements?
I believe we have church announcements. I'm trying to find Johnny so he can play music in the background. But yes,
I'm looking for an organist.
Go ahead and talk about the event you went to yesterday.
Yesterday, I attended Miss Tara Price's play, Damaged Goods, but Still Usable, I believe the name was. It was actually an amazing play, amazing stage play, especially for something in Las Vegas that was on the level and quality of Tyler Perry. So it was really amazing.
Oh, that's big.
Yeah, so it was really nice. I actually was working. I was with the photography and videography company, so I was taking pictures yesterday.
Okay.
But it was a great event. So if she does another one, hopefully she does, go out and support Vegas. Go out and support. It was an amazing event. It had mostly Vegas natives that were performing last night. Like LaShonda Pollard and her husband, Jamie, Pastor Jamie, was in there. Who else was in there? A couple other people I knew and don't know. But yeah.
You said some people I know but don't know. I'm so done with you.
I'm just saying. And then I know she brought some people in from Philadelphia, where she's from.
Okay.
And yeah, so it was good. Now, she brought in some dancers from Philadelphia. They were dope.
Okay.
I was like, okay, these are not Vegas people.
Okay. Amen.
No offense, I'm just saying.
Amen. Well, Johnny's in the building, and it's about that time for church. Church announcements.
Praise the Lord. These church announcements are brought to you by our sponsor, the Raiders.
Raiders, hallelujah.
My God. Oh, yeah, so please govern yourselves accordingly.
And the absence of Judith, that ain't here today. She heard her pinky toe coming out the bed. She hit that hard part of the bed on the corner, and it took her out for 2 weeks.
Lord, ain't nobody told me nothing.
Judith, we miss you for doing an announcement. Thank you! But hallelujah, we're gonna keep on anyway.
My God. Well, alrighty. On today, we have a special announcement. That young man, Brother Chris Johnston, he was supposed to have his Resound Worship and Arts Conference November 1st and the 2nd.
Uh-huh.
He had to postpone it because he got gout.
He got gout?
He got gout. Uh-huh.
That's just tacking.
So he had to postpone it.
You know, back in my day, we had gout, missing foot. If you look at Kunta Kinte, who was a great inspirational leader, he lost a whole foot, but it wouldn't stop the show.
Well, you know these young folk nowadays, they can't do nothing.
They get a little thumbnail, and then now they can't do nothing. So that's why the church is so different.
Yeah, so he's on medical leave for a whole month.
Yes.
Yeah, it's,
We got more people, I believe, that's having events. We got 7 women, 7 stools.
Oh, yes.
Coming up this coming up weekend, where they got 7 women. On 7 stools. It's a play to help women on stools. I believe that's how it goes. And there's going to be some great people on there. The program starts at 6. Make sure you go there. It's not like the picture show. It's an actual show. So make sure you go check out at Second Baptist. I think that's Madison Street.
Uh-huh.
Second Baptist. We got 7 women, 7 stools next weekend at 6 p.m.
Uh-huh.
Yes, sir.
And then we have the Christmas at the Cabaret.
I still don't know what a cabaret is.
I don't think I want to know.
It sounds like a house.
I don't know what it is.
I don't know. It's a cabin.
Something. It's something that
it would raise the sunshine that hits on the cabin,
yeah,
ray.
Yeah.
It got solar panels.
That's what it is.
Yeah, cabaret, yes.
Yeah, so it's Christmas at the cabin with the rays of sunshine.
Yes. Hallelujah. Because Jesus is the light of the world. Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God.
Hallelujah.
Good time. So that is in December with Brother Anton Dotson, and he has special guests coming in.
Lots of great singles.
Yeah, it's going to be at the Space Missionary Baptist Church.
I don't
know
what space we going to, but it's at that space.
That's the name of the church. It's called the Space Missionary Baptist Church. Church of God in Christ.
In the dark alley in the side.
It literally is in the dark alley on the side.
On the side of the road.
Yeah, so you're going to have to put your Google Maps on.
Make sure you're holding. For protection.
You're going to have to in that neighborhood. It's a little skeptical.
A little skeptical for some old folk like us.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I think that's all we got going.
That is the announcements.
So, hallelujah. Please govern yourselves accordingly.
Calm down.
All that bubba. What you playing for? What you playing all that now for?
All right.
Did you cut him off?
I cut him off.
Oh, well, bless God.
Amen. Amen. So that was the announcements, church announcements. One thing I want everybody to check out, make sure you stay tuned. We have Anointed Radio, got a lot of stuff coming up, especially for 2020. And now we're going to go into the mix, y'all. And I'm going to play, what was that song? There you go. We're going to go ahead and play by Jonathan Moreno's Cycles. See y'all in a minute.
Extend the game, free throws, and when it ends, he wants to make the sequel. 'Cause if he has another chance, he feels like he can take my joy, my peace, my faith. See, the devil, he learns from your mistakes. Even if you don't, that's how he keeps you in cycles, 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 cycles. But I'm not going in cycles, cycles.
Different fighter now, and I have got to think, 'cause his joy is my strength. See, the devil will learn it's a mistake when I am sure, that I'm not going in cycles. I'm not going in. So Lord, help me. Peace.
That's it.
Say it again now.
I know you as provider. is the next part.
And I'll give you all the glory, and I'll give you all the honor, because you never let me down. Lord, you came to me with good news. And when I didn't know what to do, you heard me. Yeah, you heard me in the cold of night. Oh, my other, my sustainer, you upheld me, compelled me.
Take it out. Everybody sing. Make it beautiful. Sing. That sounds good.
Amen. I know you as provider. I love that song. That song go crazy. So we are now going to go ahead and go into our interview phase. And we have welcoming to you and reintroducing to others, like they say in the church. We have Evangelist Tamika Strickland here. Everybody welcome her. Woo woo.
Amen.
Hello, everybody. God bless you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So that song, Provider, it got you too, huh? Because I know you as Provider. I love that song.
Amen. Hallelujah.
So we're going to start off with Pastor Jay's famous icebreaker question. And what would be the three best words to describe you?
Say that again, man of God.
What would be the three best words that will describe you?
I'm a powerful woman of God with a hunger to serve Him. I am grateful, and I'm just seeking to bless the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. That was somebody's word today. So, getting started into your interview, can you please tell us, you know, where is your hometown and how did you first get into ministry?
Well, back in 2014, I was introduced to a ministry called Women of Deliverance. And even though I was still wearing my grave clothes, I knew that God had a purpose for my life. And I was sick and tired of being sick and tired, so I opened myself up and I walked slowly into the will of God. And I just continued. No matter what I felt, no matter what I saw, no matter who judged me, I knew there was a purpose, because God didn't clean me up for me just to stay idle.
Amen.
That's how it began.
Amen.
Wow. Amen. So where are you naturally from, your hometown?
I was born and raised in Atlantic City. I grew up in Sicklerville. I am now in Atlantic City.
You know, that's one of the places
New Jersey.
That I wanted to go visit.
Atlantic City?
I've never been there before. I've been in a lot of places. I've been to New Jersey, but I've never been to Atlantic City. And I've been to New York. And I remember there was a time we had a reunion in New York, and all the adults left to the train to go to Atlantic City. And I was like, I want to go. And they didn't let me go. So I'm going to get there one day.
But I heard it's like Las Vegas.
Come on down and join us.
Is it the Las Vegas of the East Coast?
That's what I heard. It's the Las Vegas of the East Coast.
I definitely got to check that out. There's angels in cities like this.
Amen.
Amen. I'm serious. You know, we got our 4 miles of strip, and people just be worried about the 4 miles of strip. But think about how many ministries is out here.
Do we really have to talk about that?
Just throw that out there. I'm just saying. Now, think about Atlantic City. There's probably so many ministries that's on fire, and everybody just worried about the boardwalk. See? Same thing. Amen.
Amen.
So, Evangelist, we wanted to ask you, can you tell us a little bit about your book?
Well, Identity Deception from Wounds of Worship, the Real Life Story of Evangelist Tamika Strickland, is basically anyone that experienced emotional pain, physical abuse, depression, abandonment, rejection, and especially someone that believes that they cannot be delivered from lesbianism. Mm. I'm telling you, with the Lord, all things are possible.
Amen.
Amen.
The story of little Meek Meek and how she was always seeking attention and never had it. That little girl that was touched, and once you are touched, it doesn't matter the magnitude, but once you're touched, it's almost like your eyes have been opened to a spirit of perversion. Mm. You're not seeing from purity anymore. So basically, my book is talking about how little Meek Meek went through trials and tribulations, the ups and the downs, seeking to get clean, found Christ by getting saved first and also being baptized in the Holy Spirit, hallelujah, and walking this walk for Him. And then how the grave clothes slowly but surely came off. Like, it began with the surgery of the spirit, where you couldn't see with the natural eye. You had to have a spiritual eye to actually see what was going on in my life. Oh, Jesus, thank you, Holy Spirit. So the walk, this walk, and the identity deception, glory to God, I give him all the glory because I finally surrendered and I submitted to him no matter what, with the ups and downs, no matter what. This book, God birthed this book out. It's almost like as you're reading, you can identify. You don't have to identify with the lesbianism because we all sin. So this book will bless you. Identity deception. The wounds, everything that I've gone through. The worship, my relationship with Christ Jesus. A day at a time. Mm. A day at a time.
Wow.
So for the listener that would read your book, what is something that you wanted them to take away from reading your book that they could apply to their life?
Well, for the listeners, understand that we all have some type of trauma. And all you have to do is seek God. Whatever level that you start at, it really doesn't matter. Mm. Get connected to someone. At first, I had to get clean. So I started the recovery process. And I kept going. With 19 years clean, God started edging me towards ministry. It's all about a foundation with God. It's all about seeking Him with all your heart and with all your soul. Even if you are freed, you get up in the morning, you pray, you surrender your will and your life to the care of God and allow Him to guide you each and every day. That's just the beginning. When you set that foundation, it grows a day at a time to where I was repenting all unrighteousness, creating me a clean heart, renew within me a right spirit. I'm putting my whole armor of God on. I'm applying the blood of Jesus over my body. I'm understanding who I am and whose I am. But like I said, it's a process. I had humble beginnings. I had people that loved me through it all as I walked around looking like a man. Mm. Some people judged me. It was okay. Hurt my feelings, but I knew I had a purpose. So I'm saying to you that we all have a purpose. We seek His face daily because He will lead and guide us no matter what. No matter what. Amen. Humble beginnings, man of God.
Amen.
Humble beginnings.
Amen. My question to you would be, well, first of all, I did hear you say, make sure I say this correctly, that pretty much God inspired this book. But I really wanted to know, what made you say yes to God to finally write and chronicle your story to where it could help somebody else? What was the deciding factor to go ahead and do it?
Man of God, it's almost like I can barely hear you, and I want to hear what you're saying clearly. It's like you're real low. I turned up my sound. Can you repeat that, please?
Can you hear me now?
Okay. That's go perfect. Ahead.
Okay. So earlier, I believe I heard you say that literally God inspired this book, but I really wanted to know what made you finally say yes to the Lord to chronicle your story to where it could help someone else. What was the deciding factor for you to say, okay, God, I'll write this book?
My motivating factor was pain. And I knew that once I started writing, the vision became real. And I knew that it wasn't for me. It was someone else that didn't believe that they had a voice. My voice began in the recovery process because we would share, you know, our experience, strength, and hope. But when I started writing the book, it's like things started falling off of me. Because a book like that, you're really telling your business. So it had to be God that was driving. He was my driving force also. The more I wrote, I'm like, oh my God, I don't even remember that part of my life. But I just kept going.
So one thing I wanted to ask is, was there a scripture that you held dear to your heart during this time?
One of my favorite scriptures, Ezekiel 16:4. And when I passed by you and I saw you struggling in your blood, whatever your blood could be, it could be abuse, it could be abandonment, it could be rejection, whatever it is, I said to you in your blood, live. Yes, I said to you in your blood, live. And I just added, Tamika, live, Tamika. Because I was so afraid of living for Christ. So that was something that I built upon. Ezekiel 16:6. That became real for me.
Amen. That's what that meant. Wow, that's deep. In spite of your iniquity, live. That's powerful.
Very much so.
Because I feel like a lot of times when we go through things, we feel powerless, that, you know, the things that we are struggling with is going to consume us. Because I always love when Paul talked about doing the things I want to do, I don't do, and the things I don't want to do, I do. I think a lot of people can relate to that, where they're like, no, I don't want to be doing this. No, but it's like, obviously we know that we're not wrestling with flesh, but spirits, because spirits have a hold for a reason. And we don't, a lot of times we don't know what the reason is, but we do, because it's to be able to stop, kill, steal, and destroy, you know, all the things that we have in store for our life that God already promised us. And one thing I wanted to just ask you, Evangelist, is if somebody out there is struggling, what would be the first steps to getting right?
Well, for me, I went into a church. I had to get saved first. That's muy importante. You have to get saved first. You get connected to a loving and caring ministry. Because depending on how you come in, you're already broken. Mm-hmm. You're looking like a man. You're looking like a woman dressing as a man. It's so many different vices. But what I'm saying to you, right now, I am that one standing in the gap for anyone that's struggling with homosexuality, any type of abuse, any type of rejection, abandonment. And I am here with the Lord, the Holy Spirit, to guide anyone that is struggling. There is someone in your church, whether it's locally, you have online, that has lived that life, that is saying there is hope. It's a choice. The Holy Spirit is a gentleman. He's not going to force anything on you. Mm-hmm. But I know that if I'm constantly living in pain, I can't blame it on people, places, and things. I got to search my heart. And doing that, when you're saying, man, I'm really struggling in this area, there's someone out there. Sometimes we said something in recovery like, can I get in your pocket? Can I walk around with you? Can we pray together? Can we worship together? That's just the beginning. But in actuality, it's about building a relationship with God, getting in the Word, I was told to read the Gospels. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. That's what I was told. And as you continue to walk, even when we stumble, because in the beginning I had women following me into the church. And when I was slain in the spirit, are you going to leave me? But because of my people-pleasing issues, I said no. But I know the more the Holy Spirit was working inside of me, I knew that he was changing the condition of my heart. And I began to walk in truth. And truth is my Lord and Savior. He's my life. He's the lover of my soul. But always remember, if it's not coming from a place of love, it is not of God. Mm-hmm. Because, see, that's the problem. We can't judge because we all have skeletons in our closets.
Amen.
All of us. So when you're talking to someone that has an identity deception problem, you have to come from love, compassion, fruits of the Spirit.
Amen.
And walk with them. That's what it's about, Pastor. Mm. We got to lead and guide people that are broken as well as us. We get better in one area, then he stirs and activates something else that needs to be healed and delivered.
Amen.
So judge not. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. One thing I wanted to ask is, where can everybody find you? How can people buy your book? Because your story was compelling. You got us in the studio like, wow. Like, mm-hmm. That was deep. Yeah. So how can everybody buy your book? Where can people find you? What's your social media? What's your email? All that good stuff. Because I always believe that there's always a listener out there that's looking for somebody to have an outlet to vent to talk okay. To ask for advice. So I always wanted to leave off, you know, and there'll be somebody today that heard your story that's like, man, I really want to ask her, how did she get through, or how she did this, or the stuff that we didn't ask today. Yeah. It'll give the chance for the listener to say for tomorrow. So how can everybody get in contact with you?
Okay, Identity Deception is available on Amazon.com. It's also available in ebook through Amazon. My Facebook, Tamika Strickland. My Instagram is Strick9, it's Stricknin. I'm also available on Twitter as Tamika Strickland. My email would be TamikaStrickland43@gmail.com. I actually have something on YouTube, Tamika Strickland Ministries. And that would be it.
Amen. Y'all heard it. Go follow her. Go buy her book. Go. I mean, harass her. Go get all her social medias. Go follow her. Say hi. And she's definitely a powerful woman of God. And women of God out there that are struggling with things that you feel like you're not comfortable to go to somebody with. It's, you know, the good thing about social media that came in ministry is that you could be able to reach out to somebody mm-hmm. without worrying about everybody knowing what you're reaching out about. Because, you know, back in the day, going to the church, and everybody like, why are you going to pastor office? Why are you talking to evangelists? You know, why are you talking to deacon? Why? What y'all doing? What, and, you know, instead of that, now you could just go directly and say, hey, I've been dealing with blah, 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 and how did you get out? Because the testimony is a guideline. It's a roadmap to getting out.
Definitely.
It's showing the way of escape for each person that went through something and God got them out and delivered them from something truly. So, yes, go follow her, Evangelist Tamika Strickland. And one thing I would like to say is thank you for coming on to the show today. We really appreciate you sharing your story. You know, it's a great bravery to tell your story, because a lot of people, you know, don't feel comfortable telling their story, and you were able to tell your story and do it marvelously. I just wanted to say, And we just thank you here at Anointed Radio for spending time with us and coming on to the show. If you come out with any more books, I want to know so I could be able to promote it.
Amen.
I sure will, Pastor. God gets all the glory in this interview.
Amen.
And I thank you.
And we just appreciate you. And if there's any time that you come in Vegas and you want to come into the studio, let us know.
Definitely.
Amen.
Because, you know, God since you're in Atlantic City and we're in Las Vegas, they like my grandma would say, they kissing cousins. They almost the same thing.
Right.
Wow, Vegas.
So.
Wow. Okay, West Coast.
Right. Check us out.
Here we are.
Next time you come out here, yeah, check us out. And we really appreciate you, woman of God. And have a great day.
Have a blessed one.
Amen.
Thank
Amen.
You. Bye-bye.
Amen.
Amen.
That was deep.
Man.
Wow. That was really deep.
Yeah.
You know, one thing that I took away from that, too, is that we got to really stop the politics of church. Because it takes away the effectiveness of the church.
Amen.
Because, you know, like she said, as soon as people come, you know, one thing that I always saw weird, we want people to come to church, but when they do come to church, we got the most nastiest attitude or look in our face. That's like, who is that? I don't know them. You know them. Why does it matter? There are people that are coming to God, that's coming to your ministry, that's coming to church, that wants to know more about God, and we got to do better in our representation. Like the Kingdom Image Award says, Kingdom Image Award isn't just an award. It's talking about how we reflect the kingdom's image right. in our everyday walk, in what we say and what we do. And I was just thinking about that. It's like so many people want to get healed. So many people want to be delivered. So many people want mm-hmm. to be effective in church. But the question, body of Christ, are we allowing them to? Are we giving them the chance? Right. Are we just like, nah, you sit down. Nah, you ain't delivered. You know, it's crazy to me to think about how much stuff people go through. Because I feel like a lot of times, I'm an empath, so I'll be feeling for how people be feeling like, man, that's horrible. You know, because that's how Jesus was. Jesus was an empath. Why? It says Jesus wept. You know why Jesus wept? It was because he saw everybody in so much pain mm-hmm. when Lazarus died. And he was like, that's why he wept. Because he was able to put himself in somebody else's shoes and feel the pain that they were going through. And that is a very big trait of love, because you'd be able to see where people are coming from.
Right.
And if you don't know love, you don't know God.
Amen.
Because God is of love. And despite what we've done, despite how many times we've been disobedient, despite how many times we backslid, God has had your back in a lot of things where he could have left you to be dead in your grave.
Yeah.
So it's powerful to think about that. And that kind of gives a lot of I'm trying to think. It gives you a lot of feedback, room of growth for the church to start thinking about what percentage of people that we're leaving behind.
Right.
Because that's a big thing. Because would Jesus be pleased with how we're operating? That's something to think about. I don't know. I just had all these questions to think, because, you know, ministry is not about just on Sunday going to church, shouting, you know, squalling and singing and all that. Mm-hmm. It's about the relationships after that you maintain, especially ministers, evangelists, deacons, everybody. We're supposed to maintain people relationships to bring people to God.
Right.
So that they could be like, because the struggles don't happen on Sunday morning.
They happen Monday through Saturday.
Through whatever time frame it is.
The whole week.
Man, the whole week into the weekend month. Before Sunday. You know, like I love the Daryl Corley song, When Sunday Comes. Because there's a lot of times when you trying to hurry up and get that word, because you've been going through hell
all week.
And it's something that is something, I guess you could say, is really important. First of all, stay in your word. Have some grounded people in Christ to be able to be your foundation to call. But sometimes you'll learn, like I've learned, that God will shut all that you run into people and say, okay, open up my word and we're going to talk.
Yep.
And that's when you'll truly hear some real word that you needed in your life, that would be some groundbreaking, life-changing word where you're like, wow, I read that scripture, but right now in my situation, in my iniquity that I'm in right now, this scripture was like 10 times more effective the second time I read it, the third time I read it. So I definitely just wanted to leave that there, but Cletus.
Play, son.
Amen. Let me spread my wings, as they would say. But anyway, that is about it. We got to go to church ourselves.
Yeah, Lord.
Amen.
Y'all pray my chance. I got two today. Two services.
Oh, Jesus. Amen. It's my, at my church, Pastor Juanita Julia Christ the King, it is their anniversary. We have no person, a man of God is coming in speaking from California. And it's going to be a great event. So if you're in the area, check out Christ the King at 4160 Rancho. And come join us on our anniversary today. Amen. At 9:45, I think.
Oh, yesterday.
Yes.
Never mind, I can't talk. We start at 10.
Yeah.
So we're only 15 minutes behind y'all.
So, yes, I do sometimes miss the 11 o'clock service. Amen.
You have an 11 o'clock
service? No, we don't. It would be great, though. My Baptist ways come out for that one. Like, hey.
I'm like my mom nowadays. Like, let me go at the 8 o'clock service
and get it done
and get it over with.
That's how you know you're getting older. Just throw that out there.
I know I am getting older now.
So, with that being said, you can check out my social media at Anointed Jalon on Instagram and Twitter. Check me out at Pastor Jalon. We got a lot of things coming up soon. Lots of things coming up for Anointed Radio. If you ever thought about having a radio show, we are now open and taking applications for people's show ideas on Anointed Radio. If you need advertisement or social media marketing, we are now taking new clients you're asking me, hey Pastor Jay, how can I do that? Well, check out lvanointedradio@gmail.com and one of our associates will get to you and we'll set you up quite fine. So, with that being said, one thing I want to leave with you today is remember that to have a relationship, it takes action. And you have to put a value and a priority to have a relationship. And God wants you to put Him as a priority. And He wants you to stand out on faith, which is the action, so that you can be free of the things that's holding you back.
Well, I would leave you with this, that deliverance is a love ministry. So I would advise anybody, get into a ministry that loves you and is going to want to see you delivered and helped. That's not going to judge you, but it will literally help you.
Amen.
So again, remember, deliverance is a love ministry, and you can find me, Chris Johnston, at SaintChrisJ.com, as well as on all social media outlets, SaintChrisJ. Again, go get chasing after you. Praise the Lord. By the way, quick plug. I just recorded a whole album. So y'all be on the lookout for that. Hopefully before the end of the year, it will be out. So amen.
Amen. And don't forget to follow your favorite Marvin Gaye and Etta James love child. Dr. Marvinetta Clay.
Dr. Marvinetta Clay.
Clay Marvinetta. M. Clay. Clay Clay and M. Follow her and then go to drmarvinettaclay.com, check out Worship Forever, and hopefully she come out with Fly Away, which is a number one requested song from her.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll see y'all on Wednesday.
Amen.
Bye, y'all.